Okay, so today's lesson is 1.5, evaluating algebraic expressions. So a variable is a letter that represents any number. So a variable could be A, or B, or C, or any letters in the alphabet. A variable could also be like a square, or it could be a star. It can be anything that represents a number. So A could be 1, B could be 7, C could be 3. Any variable that represents a number. Constant is a number that can't be changed. So if I said A is equal to 1, all A's must equal 1. It cannot equal anything else but 1. If I said B is equal to 2, all B's have to equal 2. That is a constant. Algebraic expression is an expression with at least one variable. So an algebraic expression might be look like this. So say 2a is an algebraic expression, has a number and has a variable. Evaluate algebraic expressions, plug in the numbers for the variable. That is a direction that you're going to find in your classwork and homework. And here is your steps. Plug in the value for the variables. Step 2, simplify using the order of operation. So let's look at example 1. 3x minus 2, 4x is equal to 5. So what you're going to do is replace your x with the number. Okay, so you have 3. Remember, a number next to a variable means multiplication. So you put it in parentheses so you know it's multiplication, minus 2. Now order of operation tells us that we have to multiply, so I'm going to put this in parentheses. So 3 times 5 is 15 minus 2. 15 minus 2 is 13. Okay, let's look at number 2. So this is n divided by 2 plus n, for n is equal to 20. So you're going to replace all your n's with 20. So now you're going to write 20 divided by 2 plus 20. Order of operation tells us what to do what first. You should know to divide. So 20 divided by 2 is 10 plus 20, and that equals 30. Go ahead and try number 3, and when you're ready, go ahead and push play. So you should have known to replace all your y's with 3. So you have 6 times 3 squared plus 2 times 3. Right, order of operation tells us that we have to square things first, or because it's exponents. So you have 6 times 3 squared is 9 plus 2 times 3. Okay, order of operation tells us to multiply next, left to right. So we're going to multiply 6 times 9 is 54 plus 2 times 3. We still have to multiply, so 54 plus 6. And you will get 60 as your answer. All right, try one that's a little bit more difficult. Try 4 and 5 on your own, and when you're ready, you can go ahead and push play. This is a little bit more challenging because you have two variables, but it's still the same steps. You've replaced your variable x with 3 and your variable y with 2. So you have 8 times 3 minus 4 times 2. Multiply, 8 times 3 is 24 minus 8, and you'll get 16. Number 5, you're going to replace your q's with 8, your p's with 12, and your r's with 7. So you have 10 times 8 minus 12 divided by 2 plus 7. Well, order of operation tells us we have to multiply, so you have 80 minus 12 divided by 2 plus 7. Then you have to divide, so it's 80 minus 6 plus 7. Order of operation tells us we have to subtract next, so you have 74 plus 7, and you'll get the answer of 81.